Good. Happy Wednesday evening, everyone. I'm Riley King, and welcome to this Wednesday evening edition of Sports with Riley King. Let's begin. First up, the Boston Celtics. They had a game last night, and let's take a look at their final score from their game last night. And here's a check of the final score from their game last night. Boston Celtics, 111, and Golden State Warriors, 107. The Boston Celtics won the game last night. Congratulations, Boston Celtics. And the Boston Celtics, they play tonight at 10 o'clock p.m. at Sacramento Kings. Game time at 10 o'clock p.m. You can watch tonight's game on League Pass and NBC Sports. Let's go Boston Celtics. And also the Boston Bruins, they play tonight at 8 o'clock p.m. Boston Bruins at Philadelphia Flyers. You can watch tonight's game on NBC. Let's go Boston Bruins and Boston Celtics. Two Boston teams playing a game tonight. Nashua Dodgers lead way to integration in America baseball. Team had first integration roster in sports. Let's take a listen to that video from WMUR News 9.
The 1940s.
With the Bank of America Cash Rewards credit card, preferred rewards members can earn up to 5.25% cash back on online shopping, making the essentials even more rewarding.
For a transformative time for American baseball, the great players of the Negro Leagues had no path to the majors until Brooklyn Dodgers manager Branch Rickey paved the way, signing Jackie Robinson, Roy Campanella, and Don Newcomb to minor league contracts.
All three of them, they tried to package them to bring them into a league, and certain leagues, like in Illinois, threatened to close the entire league down if they sent three players of color.
Robinson went to Montreal, where black athletes faced less discrimination at the time. Rickey then looked for a similar surrounding for Campanella and Newcomb.
Nashville itself was unique because of the Franco-American influence that they were a lot more tolerant than any other location in the country.
Their talents spoke for themselves. I mean, they probably shouldn't have been at this level of baseball. They were so much more talented than their teammates.
Campanella and Newcomb ascended as two of the top players in the league, quickly earning the respect of their teammates and coaches.
The manager of the Lynn Red Sox, a guy named Pip Kennedy, ran into Buzzy Bivasi after the game and said, you know, you guys wouldn't have beaten us if it wasn't for those, and then dropped the N-word. And Bivasi just freaked out, and they had to be separated.
The Nashua Dodgers won the title in 1946. Newcomb, who led the team to another championship in 1947, has a plaque outside Holman Stadium. And both players' numbers hang on the stadium that provided a gateway of integration into American pro sports.
They could have been the greatest ball players you've ever seen, but if they weren't accepting of the situation that they were in, and they weren't treated as well as they were by not only the organization but the people that came to games, I think we would have had a much different story.
Mike Cherry, WMUR News 9.
Okay, and there you go on that video and that report. And that does it for this Wednesday evening edition of Sports with Riley King. Have a great rest of your Wednesday evening, everyone. I'll see you back here tomorrow for another edition of Sports with Riley King. Good night, goodbye, everyone.